Good morning. I will recite for you excerpts from The Present and Future of the Colored Race in America by Frederick Douglass. Ladies and gentlemen, I think that most of you will agree with me in respect to the surpassing importance of the subject we are here to consider this evening. Though you may differ with me in other respects, it seems to me that the relation subsisting between the white and colored people of this country is, of all other questions, the great, paramount, imperative, and all-commanding question for this age and nation to solve. It cannot be denied that the question, what shall be done with the Negro, now stands before us as one of life and death. We are encompassed by it as by a wall of fire. The flames singe and burn us on all sides, becoming hotter every hour. I stand here tonight, therefore, to advocate what I conceive to be such a solid basis, one that shall fix our peace upon a rock. Putting aside all the hay, wood, and stubble of expediency, I shall advocate for the Negro his most full and complete adoption into the great national family of America. I shall demand for him the most perfect civil and political equalities, and that he shall enjoy all the rights, privileges, and amenities enjoyed by any other members of the body politic. I weigh my words, and I mean all I say, when I contend, as I do contend, that this is the only solid and final solution of the problem before us. It is demanded not less than by the terrible exigencies of the nation, than by the Negro himself, for the Negro and the nation are to rise or fall, be killed or cured, saved or lost together. Save the Negro and you save the nation. Destroy the Negro and you destroy the nation. And to save both, you must have but one great law of liberty, equality, and fraternity for all Americans without respect to color. But the question is, can the white and colored people of this country be blended into a common nationality and enjoy together under the same flag in the same country the inestimable blessings of life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness as neighborly citizens of a common country? I believe they can. The fact is, my friends, we are opening a new account with the American people and with the whole human family. Hitherto, we have been viewed and have viewed ourselves as an impotent and spiritless race, having only a mission of folly and degradation before us. But tonight we stand at the portals of a new world, a new life, and a new destiny. We have passed through the furnace and have not been consumed. We have illustrated the fact that the two most opposite races of men known to ethnological science can live in the same latitudes, longitudes, and altitudes, and that so far as natural causes are concerned, we have reason to believe that we may permanently live under the same skies and the same country. And we may share the inestimable blessings of life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. Thank you.